Oh my goodness. We're starting Birth by Sleep, aka Sad Sad Story. But let's not get into spoilers for anyone new. So we're starting Birth by Sleep. We finished Kingdom Hearts 2 just a little while ago. We got to continue on this blustering pace if we're going to beat Kingdom Hearts 3's release for all these games. I'm excited. It's been a long time since I played Birth by Sleep. A long, long time. Long, long time. So we're going to play, if you're new to Birth by Sleep, if you have no idea what this game is, it's a prequel, which you'll learn very shortly. And it follows three protagonists. There's three stories. You play each of them at different times. If you're a fucking madman, you could play them at different rates and play a little bit of this character, play a little bit of that character. I definitely don't recommend that. I don't think anyone would recommend that. It seems like a dumb thing to do. You should be doing it just one at a time. And there is a preferred order I like that I think a lot of people like, and that's what I'll be doing. I'm going to... Pardon the blue screen here. Alright, just had to check something there on the audio really quick. So yeah, we're going to... My hair is all up in my face. I had just taken a shower and I'm all... Hair just everywhere. So we'll click new game. Now you don't know what I'm going to pick, right? Previous Kingdom Hearts games, other than 2, I'd been doing just standard. Kingdom Hearts 2, I went to Proud. A thrilling challenge packed with powerful enemies. We're not gonna do critical. We're not doing beginner. So which do you think I'm gonna pick? I'm gonna pick Proud. Let's go. Vibration always on. Vibration always on. Again, other than what I've told you a little bit about the game, I'm gonna, you know, let the game speak for itself beyond that. But I'm excited to play this. It's been a while since I played Birth by Sleep. We'll be playing a little introductory part to the game too before we jump into the main character that we'll be starting off as. I don't know if this will get VOD muted, but we'll see. I really like this opening cutscene. They really did well with this opening cutscene. I remember playing this on the PSP back in the day. Woo! As a youngin', I couldn't believe I was getting Kingdom Hearts on the PSP. I was glad I had a PSP. I know you can't see me, but I'm kind of dancing along to this song. Also, apologies if I sound just the slightest bit congested. I think I had gotten just a little bit sick a little while ago. Now again, if you're like, if you're watching this, either live or archived, and you're like, I have no idea what the hell is going on, you'll learn. But I do get, when I first booted up this game and I got this cinematic, I was like, what the fuck? I was like, should I know what this is? Because in previous games, you know, in our timeline, in the real world timeline, you play, and the cinematics, except for maybe Kingdom Hearts 1, obviously, but unless I'm just really overthinking it, all that the cinematics were really like recaps of the previous games. And so this you saw and you're like, should I, like, who are those boys? But you know, it's just you see this and you're like, I don't know who these people are. Should I know who these people are? Should I know what this place is?
This world is just too small.
My ear was really itchy there for a second. Itchy ear. Shade. It's Roxas.
Who's there?
Also, because it's a PSP game, we get the blocky, big lettered subtitles, not like the normal ones we're used to. Kind of bugged me they couldn't just go back and kind of adjust the size of the subtitles once they migrated this to console. Small complaint, but you know, I gotta be a balanced Kingdom Hearts fan. Gotta have some complaints. Can't just be an ultimate fanboy. I'm a brand new heart. The light brought me. I saw a shining in the distance, ... and followed it here.
Yeah. That was my light.
It was my light.
But my heart is fractured. And now, the little I have left is slipping away.
Join your heart with mine. Me, whenever a friend is feeling down and out, I'm like, join your heart with mine. I will take on your burdens. I will help you. Strong enough to win back the part. I'm gonna sound the slightest bit hypocritical, because in Kingdom Hearts 2 I was like, man, people who complain about the Roxas beginning section of the game are crazy or whack.
Open the door.
But here I am kind of being like, oh dang, I have to do the opening thing to Birth by Sleep, which is not that bad. I don't even think it's that long. But I am sounding a bit hypocritical in that I'm like, man, opening to Kingdom Hearts 2, not bad. The little introductory thing to Birth by Sleep, even though it's probably shorter, it's a little bad. But it's whatever. It's whatever. I'll be fine. I'll survive. It's a video game. Yes. Me hand. Ah.
A keyblade.
Yes. Now, if I know anything about Kingdom Hearts, it's that that is Roxas. Without a shadow of a doubt, 100%, not going to be any other character that just looks like Roxas. It is Roxas. It's a lame joke, but I have to say it.
A meteor shower.
The parallels to Roxas are uncanny. Knock out this beginning thing. I'm not gonna get, like I said, I'm letting the game speak for itself mostly throughout the series, but the one thing I'll say about Birth by Sleep that I think they did really well on combat, okay, complaints are there, but the amount of what the fuck moments in the story make this game really good. In my eyes. In my humble opinion. The amount of moments where I'm like, oh my god, gives the boost to this game. Press the options button to view basic controls. Head for the summit. There are those basic controls. What is R3 to recenter? Oh, okay, well. Oh, I'm so used to Kingdom Hearts 2 movement, and I had such a high jump, and I could fly. And I can't do shit with him. Alright. With this unnamed boy. That's fine. We gotta get to a summit to see a meteor shower. Oh. Oh, some dangly bobs.
I've got time to spare.
No, you don't. Press X to attack the ring. Keep attacking the string together, a powerful combo. Immediately ignores the ring. Look at this table. Look at these chairs that I can't get on. Just keep in mind, everyone. This is, it was a handheld game. All limitations. Just... Yeah. You can earn prizes by defeating enemies or hitting things in the field. Green prizes restore HP. Yellow ones give you money. Your command deck contains special moves. Use that or that. Select one, then press triangle to use it once the gauge is filled.
What? You want a piece of me too?
It's inanimate. You can't talk to it. It can't talk to you. I do not like using the L2 R2 for that. Okay, let's see. Go arrow. And lock on to target so that the camera automatically keeps them in view. Lock on by tapping R1. I locked onto it. Yay. Once you're locked on, you can switch targets by tapping that or tap R1 to exit lock on. Simple enough. Open the treasure chest. Sliding dash. You found the sliding dash command. Press options over the main menu where you can install it in your command deck. You just said you had time to spare. Oh. Quick foot. Arrow. Alright. Look at these stats. Alright, so we're gonna... Man, if you liked in Kingdom Hearts 2 all the menu scrolling and everything I was doing, boy, are you gonna get plenty of that in this game. Meet certain requirements to power your finish command. Your finish command may power up in different ways depending on which command conditions you fulfill. Yeah, so this is not gonna make a ton of sense to new people looking at this for the first time. But basically, Birth by Sleep's combat is all based on leveling up commands and finish commands and your special moves and your shot locks and unlocking things by doing things repeatedly to gain experience points to then run. It is a thing. Give commands new names. I don't know who the hell gives their commands new names. It's a thing you can do, but no one does that. Come on. Punish those with a flurry of quick attacks. Damn. So, yeah. Yep. Abilities are bonus skills tied to commands. Just stall the command to gain ability. Abilities boost stats, provide special skills. Gain a new ability by adding a synthesis item when melding commands. Oh yeah, there's a whole command melding thing, and you synthesize abilities, and to get abilities, you have to put items on the commands, and then level up the commands, then permanently gain the abilities. Oh my goodness, it's, like I said, it's a big old thing. Quick Blitz has reached the maximum level, so its scan is now yours to keep. Auto abilities stay active even if you don't have them installed. So there's scan. But yeah, here's all these abilities you can get. Obviously your items. All I have is the Wayward Wind, his basic keyblade. The keyblade you start out with what it lacks in reach makes up for with a slight boost in strength. He's got a pretty cool looking keyblade. And I like his reverse grip he has. I've always appreciated that. Install commands in your deck. To use them, start by using Edit Deck. There are different types, yep. Get a command faster by setting a shortcut with that. Your current shortcut is highlighted in yellow. In combat, you can jump right to your shortcut by pressing left button. Commands will level up increase in power as you collect CP. Defeat enemies to get CP. Commands at the maximum level are marked with a crown. So, you got all your abilities. Let's put sliding dash there. Also, I have a certain way I like my abilities. Boop, 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 boop. Perform a jumping attack, far away enemies, throw a keyblade, call on wind. Cool. Jump. Press circle to jump. Shot locks. I don't have those. Alright, so we did it, guys.
Wow.
So mid, y'all.
Why does it seem so familiar?
Hello.
Give me a break, Aqua.
Ven, you hopeless sleepyhead. You know, you should have at least brought a blanket.
But did I dream that place up? It really felt like I'd been there before, looking up at the stars.
Except you've always lived here with us.
Yeah. I know. Hey, Aqua.
Hmm?
You ever wonder what stars are? Where light comes from?
Hmm. Well, they say
that every star up there is another world.
Huh? Alright, so except for maybe this man, Terra's outfit.
Yep.
But even not too bad, this one. I really like the character outfits in this game.
Light is their hearts.
I like Ven's, I like Aqua's. Even Terra's is fine. It's a little goofy, but...
What? I don't get it.
That's my opinion.
Just like you, Ven.
What does that mean?
You'll find out someday, I'm sure.
I
want now,
to know
voice
now.
Acting.
You're too young to know now.
That's a bit different.
Quit
that's a different story.
Like a
hey, what are you laughing at?
I can't help it. You two would make the weirdest brothers.
Huh?
Exactly. Huh?
Yeah. Terra, you and I have our Mark of Mastery exams tomorrow.
Mark of Mastery.
I made us good luck charms.
Whoa.
Here.
I get one too?
Of course. One for each of us.
Yeah.
Somewhere out there, there's this tree with star-shaped fruit. And the fruit represents an unbreakable connection. So as long as you and your friends carry good luck charm shaped like it, nothing can ever drive you apart. You will always find your way back to each other. Technically, I think you're supposed to make them with seashells. But I did the best with what I had.
Oi, sometimes you are such a girl.
Hey, what do you mean sometimes?
So this isn't a real good luck charm?
Well... that's yet to be seen. But I did work a little magic on it.
Really? What?
Magic.
An unbreakable connection.
It's the Wayfinder, one of three good luck charms Aqua made for herself and her friends the day before the Mark of Mastery exam. Oh, that's another mechanic in this game. The D-Links. Borrow your friend's powers. I know I'm talking like I don't like this game. I actually really do like this game. It's just a very interesting game in the series. The Wayfinder allows you to dimension link with friends. D-link. And borrow their powers. You will meet lots of characters throughout the story that you can D-link with.
Well, tomorrow's the exam. Anybody want to spar?
Want to fight?
I can take you.
Want to tussle? Oh, I'm playing as Terra. This HP gauge represents your health. Run out of HP and you will be defeated. Use square to defend yourself. Press it while moving to slide. Or press square while holding still to block. Block. Alright, so Terra is all about slow and strong. Leave me alone. Alright, let's beat him up. What? How did I get hit there? Block. I just smacked you a couple times. This command gauge fills when your attacks hit enemies. If you get a few seconds without landing attack, it'll start to drain. Once you fill the gauge all the way, you can devastate opponents with the powerful finish command. Bam. 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 Finish. Want some? Using triangle command instead of regular attack to fill command gauge may cause you to change command styles. Command styles make your square or X cross attacks more, whatever. Which command style you get depends on the commands you use to fill the gauge. You unlock more as you progress. Some command styles are tricky to activate. Try all kinds of command combinations.
Well, that works fine if you're fighting one-on-one. But but you need to know how to handle a crowd, too.
Oh, really? Alright, play another lock for now. Use your shot lock command to hit lots of enemies at once. Hold down R1, and a big target circle will appear. Use the left stick to point the circle at one or more enemies and lock on multiple times. While still holding R1, press X to use your shot lock, which hits enemies as many times as you locked on. Alright. Oh yeah, she has the cartwheel. The one-handed cartwheel. Oh, it's this one, huh? Ow! I got him. Oh, hey! Thank you for the raid. I really appreciate that. Shot lock attacks require focus. Poke gauge will drain when you use them. Thank you, I appreciate it. I will enjoy this stream. Appreciate it, though.
Okay, let's wrap this up.
Let's wrap it up. He says confidently. Choose a character for this fight. We gotta go with Girl Aqua. Come on. Come on. Am I just supposed to beat him up? Oh, I've got... I'm still used to Kingdom Hearts 2. Got him. Oh, I'm the best.
Looks like I win.
Shove it right in your face. Want to spar again? No, come on. Let's not get carried away here.
Trust me. You guys are ready. We're gonna clean up with the exam tomorrow.
Trust me, nothing bad will happen tomorrow at the exam.
Master said, power is born within the heart. When the time is right, you just need to look inside yourself, and you'll find it there.
You'll find it. Power is born within the heart. During your travels, you can find new strength by playing on the command board. God damn, I forgot about the... Okay, in this game, you'll roll the dice and power up your commands as you make your way along the board. You can access command board at save. Yeah, commands, yeah. It's like a weird way of powering up. You just play a little board game.
You don't want to lose track of stuff that's happened.
That's a good point, Ben. Very, very good point. See, I'm already pressing the wrong buttons to save. Got Kingdom Hearts 2 on the brain. Ho! Pardon the blue screen. Totally forgot it takes you to a separate menu for that. Alright, we're back. We'll try to keep saving to a minimum. Why has it gotta, I mean, again, that's a small thing when it brought to console. They could have just changed the save system to just be all housed in game. Doesn't have to be like this, Square. Alright, we're getting through this beginning thing. We're gonna reach a critical story point, and then we'll be in full force.
Together. Always.
Foreshadowing.
That would be the last night we ever spent beneath the same stars.
Yep. So not together always. She lied.
Ooh.
Oh no. I love his Birth by Sleep outfit. Just putting that out there. Mickey origin story.
Mickey, I cannot shake the feeling something terrible is about to transpire.
I agree. It's a younger, more inquisitive Mickey. Here we go. Now we're picking. Alright, so like I said at the beginning, if you're unfamiliar with this game, it's three parallel stories. If you're a madman, you'll play them at the same time, but really you should just be doing one at a time. You'll choose one character at a time and complete their story from start to finish. Each character visits different places and meets different people. Only by finishing all three stories will uncover the tale's deeper truths. Obviously, you could pick whatever order you want, but again, most people in the fan will say you gotta play as Terra first, and then Ventus, and then Aqua. This is a good order. So we'll go a disciplined young man who feels compelled to find greater strength. He relies on brute force in combat. He's happy you picked him. Looks to the sky. Huh? Pointy shoes. Like I said, I love the outfits in this game. They're like,
today you will be examined for the mark of mastery.
A mix of relaxing, comfortable clothes with like battle armor.
Nor a battle for supremacy. Not a test of wills, but a test of heart. Both of you may prevail, or neither. But I am sure our guest, Master Xehanort, did not travel all this way to see our youngest prospects in years fall short of the mark. I trust you are ready.
Oh, I'm so ready.
Then let the examination begin.
I love this part. Let the examination begin. Hit the balls. Oh no. Some shady stuff happening. Ben, protect yourself.
Don't worry about me. You two focus on the exam.
But Ben, you're in danger here. Go wait in your room.
Those balls are very dangerous.
I've been looking forward to this. Seeing you two become masters. I'm not gonna miss it now.
He can take care of himself. He's been out there training just as hard as us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stay sharp, Ben.
Destroy the orbs of light. Okay, that's how you switched on. Oh, the ball's trying to escape. I missed. Ow. Wait, don't I have a... Oh, jeez. That was bad. That's how we do it. Oh my goodness. The light balls are attacking back. There we go, maximum HP and critical impact. Although it's a bit convoluted, the whole leveling up system in this game and commands and everything, it at least gives you like a bit of like a collection aspect to the whole game that I kind of enjoy. If you fill up the command gauge, at least partly using deck commands, you'll sometimes change command styles. Command styles get you depends on how many and which deck commands you used.
That was unexpected. But one must keep a still heart even in the most trying of circumstances. It was an excellent test, one I chose to let unfold. Which brings us to your next trial. Now, Terra and Aqua, the two of you will face each other in combat.
Remember, winner.
There are no winners, only truths.
But there are definitely losers. When
the powers clash, their nature is revealed. Begin.
Oh. Uh-oh. Yes. He likes.
We have deliberated and reached a decision. Terra, Aqua, you both performed commendably. However, only Aqua has shown the mark of mastery. Terra, you failed to keep the darkness within you sufficiently in check.
Damn.
But there is always next time. That is all. Aqua, as our newest Keyblade Master, you are entitled to certain knowledge. Please wait here for further instruction.
Terra, go fuck off.
Hey.
Terra, I'm sorry.
The darkness, where did it come from?
What do you make of Ventus?
He ain't gonna cut it.
Dang.
Somebody's gotta break that loser in.
Not here, you won't. I have to keep up appearances.
I know that. He just needs a little incentive to leave home.
Sorry. But I need some time alone.
He's like, I'm out.
There's darkness within me. So what does that matter?
Moody, moody boy.
I know I'm strong enough to hold it back.
Yes.
Yes.
You are indeed strong.
I was just over listening.
Darkness is nothing to fear.
Master Xehanort.
And yet... how frustrating that Ericus refutes its power. Why, you could train with him forever, and still, you'd never be a master in his eyes.
Planting the seeds.
But why? Help me understand, Master Xehanort. What is it that I failed to learn?
You're fine as you are. Darkness cannot be destroyed. It can only be channeled.
Yes. Thank you, Master.
Ah, you've taught me so much. This isn't eerie at all. It is not like you're trying to sow seeds of doubt in my feeble brain at all. Like, Terra is just a big old dumb idiot throughout this game. Just an idiot.
I don't know. Why isn't Ven here?
Very well, then. I will send my pupils to investigate. Yes, I understand. Farewell. That was my dear old friend Yen Sid.
Yen Sid.
As you know, he is master no more. But he still keeps a close eye on the tides of light and darkness. His counsel serves as signposts on the road we wielders of the Keyblade must walk. All the more reason then for concern, for he tells me the princesses of heart are in danger. Not only from the forces of darkness, as you may assume, but also from a new threat.
New threat.
That feeds on negativity. Fledgling emotions that have taken monster form. Yen Sid calls them the Unversed.
It's a pretty good name for him.
As wielders of the Keyblade, you are tasked with striking down any who would upset the balance of light and darkness. The Unversed are no exception. I tried to pass this news on to Master Xehanort, but my repeated attempts to reach him have
failed. He's just mysteriously disappeared.
Any connection in it.
Yeah, I doubt there's any connection. Come on,
Master
man.
Xehanort?
is gone.
Come on, man.
So here
a lot
are.
Of the unfortunate events in this game could have been solved with some just a bit of common sense on some of their parts.
And find Master Xehanort. I have unlocked the lanes between. You may use these forbidden pathways to travel between this world and countless others. The darkness looms closer than usual within these spaces, but your armor will protect you. Lastly, remember that order must be kept. You cannot tell anyone there are other worlds. Now go and fulfill your duty.
Disney continuity hangs in the balance of you not letting other Disney characters know other Disney characters exist.
Consider this an opportunity. A second chance for you to change my mind.
What?
You must know. I care for you like my own son. If I could have my way, I would name you master in a second.
Lies.
But how can I, when you are so obsessed with power? Terra, you mustn't be afraid of losing. Fear leads to obsession with power, and obsession beckons the darkness. You must never forget.
Never forget.
Thank you, Master. I swear, I will not fail you again.
Oh. Terra!
Terra!
It's okay.
Oh yeah, I was when I first saw this, the concept of them like hitting the little thing and then getting all clad in armor, I was like, that's kind of dumb. But then I was like, you know what? I had to change a heart. A young Austin had to change a heart midway through this game, and I was like, you know what? It's pretty cool. I'm with it. I'm not gonna be a hater. Forged a D-Link with Ventus. It's a D-Link. Alright, while D-Linked, you can use other characters' commands. Press that to open your list of D-Links. Steel Link gauge will drain as long as you remain linked. When the gauge runs out, your link will be broken. D-Linking fully restores your HP. Refill the gauge by collecting these D-Link prizes. Defeating enemies while D-Linked may cause them to drop special emblems. Collect the emblems to power up the D-Link. Forge a D-Link with Aqua as well. A world plane! Unlock the command board for the Land of Departure. Land of Departure. Alright, well, we're not going to do that. We're going to play the game. I'll do what I most likely would do, because the doing the command board game is actually really helpful and sometimes necessary. I'll probably do those off stream. Just to, you know, get some good abilities, level up abilities. You know, things of that nature, so that it's not... Even though, like, I'm sure I could do it on stream and be like, oh, I'm playing a fucking board game. It also just seems like it would just be best if just, like, on nights where I'm not streaming or whatever, I can just easily do the command board and get those out of the way. So critical impact impacts when you activate, I mean, when you use attacks like Quick Blitz. Of course, finish smite foes with powerful jumping attack. D-Links. So we've got Ventus. So he's got Blast of Wind, and then Flurry of Quick Attacks and Command Deck Magic of each element, volleys of magic in all directions. And then you can actually see what the full... She's got Cure, which is nice, especially early on. He's got some attacks. We'll see if I actually end up using a lot of those. Scans there. Scan is there. We've got Earthshaker, the capability to start out with. What it lacks in reach, it makes up for it with a slight boost in strength. It's a big ol' Big old keyblade. I got Wayfinder. And then the last thing I need to check is this. Yep, jump slide block. Jump slide block. Sonic Shadow becomes one with the shadows and rush target repeatedly, blinding the enemies you hit. Do I have anything else? No. Alright, we're good. We are good to go. So this is the world map. Kind of similar to King Arts 2. And you can get blasted, right? Like, go away. We don't want you back on this world, Terra. You're full of darkness. Alright, so we land. Enchanted Dominion will be our first world. Zap, zap. See Enchanted Dominion. Alright, we get our first look at the enemies of this game.
The ones the master mentioned.
Look at how cute he is. They're adorable. While I'm kind of meh on some of the designs of the Unverse, they, of the enemy types, Shadow, or, the Heartless, Nobodies, and the Unverse, they definitely have the most adorable designs. Like, they've got the most enemies that are like, oh, they're so adorable. Here we go. So yeah, when you level up, when you fight with certain commands, then you get like a new fighting style. As you can see. And that gives you better attacks like this. And you can smack them around. So it's beneficial to not just use X attacks. I have to readjust the camera. It's like a weird, it's slightly different camera feel to than Kingdom Hearts 2. So I keep looking, I was like weirdly looking at the ground a lot there. Oh, look at him! He's running!
No, you don't.
Yes, he does. Alright, so let's open up these treasure chests. Thought I saw another one. Pulsing crystal. Look at this. Now is no time to explore. Well, says you. I think the reason why it makes it look like I'm staring at the ground is just how the worlds are built and like what you're looking at. Because if you go like this where you want to look at the world, then your angle of like fighting what's in front of you is not really well. It's not like... like, seeing Heartless, like, or Unversed is not good at this angle when you're fighting. So you gotta kind of tilt down a bit. But then you're looking at, like, the ground like this. And not, like... it's just a weird... it's just how the game's weirdly built because of how small it is and how the world is. But, again, small complaints. See, like, I keep going like this so I can see where I'm walking. But I have a natural tendency to want to, like... Boy, I should feel like I should be seeing the world like this. Stickers. Now when I accidentally say stickers, it'll make sense. And I'm not, and I don't mean to say puzzle pieces. Just tune into the Kingdom Hearts 2 stream and you'll see what I'm trying to say. Also, I'm gonna keep saving to a minimum just so that we don't have to go to that blue screen. Like a crazy person. Title card. What else can I talk about other than the game? Oh, so I started watching a new show that I was very reluctant to start watching just because it, from the outside, it always looked really dumb to me. Why aren't you asleep, boy? It's that Rooster Teeth anime, Ruby. I started watching that and I gave it a fair shot. And it's actually not the worst thing ever. And it's really quick and short and like bite-sized. So it's really easy to just kind of like in bunches just watch it. And I was actually impressed. I thought I was going to not like it at all. But if you stick through it, it does. I have very more extended feelings about it, but it does really well the first two seasons, kind of like laying a fine groundwork kind of thing, and then it really ramps up in season three in like a really good way. Actually, fairly interesting. That name is not familiar. Again, it's not fantastic. Is he an outsider like yourself? But it's decent. I do remember someone leaving
the castle. Tell me, what was he doing there?
Also, during this cutscene, Terra just gets played like a fiddle. That's all it is, basically. That's why I don't mind talking over it. Go see the castle for yourself. There, the entrance is past the bridge. The thing that Ruby Show does the best is... Perhaps he did speak. Something about, like, the fighting is fine. The fighting scenes are pretty good. But the best thing it does is the world it's set up and, like, the mechanics of combat and fighting. So, like, the small little things where you're like, oh, that makes sense in a fighting... Like, unless you've seen it, what I'm trying to say wouldn't make much sense. But it's not so much the combat, like, fighting scenes that are great, but, like, the mechanics of combat for the enemies and stuff, the people, it's like, oh, that's actually kind of a cool concept. Cool concepts in that show, basically. That's what that... Let's do a D-Link. Ventus, go! Strength increase, magic increase. Ow. The D-Link gauge will go very slowly down. Oh! The first death, because I'm not paying attention. I forgot that I'm playing on critical. Alright, let's just redo that. Like that never happened, okay? Haste. There we go. Your attacks are faster, which is kind of cool. So yeah, when you use D-Link, you basically... It's like I'm pretty sure like an EXP system built into the... D-Links themselves. Oh, collect crown stickers throughout each world. Then you can arrange them in a sticker album. Pay enough points, you'll receive items. Oh, I might as well check that out, right? Sticker album. So these are the items you can get from it. Sticker collection. And then so you go in here and the whole thing is like, oh, if you put it here, then you get 5 points. Blah. What you want is 7 points. So they have like ranges where you're supposed to put them. Like that. Like if you get 7 and it gives you that sound, then you're like, oh, I placed it in a right area. Obviously they're balloons. They want you to put it in the sky. That's basically all it boils down to. So that's that mechanic. But yeah, the D-Links have their own like EXP system. So then when you get like an ability, that's where they're really nice, because obviously they level up and you get more battle commands. So there I got added at either strike rate or sliding dash or whatever. But skill set gets added and haste, and so your attacks are faster and stuff. So it's actually very handy. Also, I need to be watching out because I'm about to die again like an idiot. I gotta remember that if you're doing crit or proud early on, you gotta make sure you're not dying because you don't have a ton of abilities. Alright, so let's link with Aqua here. She's got magic. Does that make me level 2? Oh, shit. Another annoying thing in this game is when you pause, it'll take you out of your command style, like your fighting style, or your D-Link for some reason. Like, it's obnoxious, and it also, like, that's probably my main complaint with this game, gameplay-wise. It's like, it's just frustrating that happens. Like, it shouldn't be like that. Oh, I forgot Thunder isn't like that. Also, I'm glad Aqua comes with a cure spell, so I can kind of be better. Magic Blast. Magic Doodads. And it heals your health though, so by D-Linking. So it's kind of like form changes almost in King Arts 2, where it could heal you. So it's actually really nice and helpful. Magic Deflector. So I think that either you can block magic attacks, or probably magic attacks don't hurt you as much or something. One of those two. But I do like how you can like revert back at any point and then save the D-Link gauge. If you wanted to try to like D-Link sooner again to then restore health. It's actually a very convenient way of keeping health. Blizzard, zero gravity, potion. So you start to see that I'm gaining some different abilities. So I'm gonna edit this. I'm gonna put zero gravity on there. I'm gonna do that. Put this shortcut on there. And then this is how melding, you create a new command by melding two existing ones. Command you meld, have to reach a high enough level. Just set aside one melding to add an ability. So that's how you kind of level up. And so you got to constantly be making sure you're doing that to get new abilities and new commands that are better. So like I said, I'm gonna be in the menus a lot in this game. I hope, like I said, a lot of the time, hopefully that'll be done off stream. But just so you know, and also in saying that, it's because a lot of that and like leveling up on the command board and everything will be off stream. Every time I stream this game, then there's a good chance that like I'll have abilities that you'll be like, oh, where did those come from? And you just gotta know that those were probably gotten off stream. Drift. Because the whole point of this game is it encourages constantly changing what you've got on your loadout, basically. Look at this nice little room. Huh. Definitely can't get there. I tried to block it. Zero gravity becomes a very nice ability to have. Like, look at that. Just basically incapacitates them, and then you're just able to just smack them around a bit. About to level up again. Oh, come on. Get out of the ground. Let's examine the door.
This feels so familiar.
Her heart is filled with light. Not the slightest touch of darkness. Just the kind of heart I need.
For what?
Imagine with me the most glorious of futures. Seven of the purest hearts, each overflowing with light. When brought together, they grant the power to rule all worlds.
What do you mean?
Why, that key you hold. The Keyblade is
the Keyblade.
How did you learn that name?
That trinket is the only way to obtain the hearts.
No more games! Where is Master Xehanort?
Impudence will get you nowhere, child. If you wish to learn more, you must retrieve the heart of Aurora.
Take her heart, man.
And why would I ever want to do that?
It's not a matter of why, but of will. In your heart, there is darkness just waiting to be awakened.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Mm-mm.
Perhaps not yet. But I have power over sleep. And I can awaken what's inside you. Then you will be free to be who you truly are.
Remember, darkness lurks in every heart. Darkness is our foe. Would that we could be rid of it. You must destroy it. Push the darkness down. Give it no quarter in your heart.
Keeps having to do the pose. Uh-oh. No, Terra, you fool.
Here it is. Just what I've waited for. To think that all he spoke of was and will be true.
What? How did it...
Terra.
What did I do? What did you do?
You speak as if I pulled some invisible strings. No, you couldn't be further from the truth, child. I simply whispered to the darkness you already held inside.
How could I do this? Finn!
Yes. Now, you want to know where Xehanort went.
Well, Xehanort. Xehanort.
I cannot answer. He disappeared into the darkness. But now I know the Keyblade is necessary to gather hearts. Join me. Collect 6 more hearts of pure light. Then we will rule all the worlds together!
Lol, no.
You seem to be mixed up. I'm a peacekeeper, not a tyrant.
Kill her.
For a peacekeeper, you're off to an exceptionally poor start. Remember this. The darkness in your heart cannot be held back by force or strength. Now, my work here is done, as is yours. Wasn't there someone you needed to chase?
Wait!
Oh, if only he didn't do that flourishy move, maybe he would have gotten her before she disappeared.
The Unburst. They're gonna bring down the castle. I have to do something.
Forged a D-Link with Maleficent. Oh my goodness. Alright, so we got a Moogle shop. We got a giant chest. Map. El Mappe. Here we go, shop. What's he got? He's got a lot of abilities that you can buy. Blizzard Zero, Fuse Poison Sleep. The thing about the shop is what's gonna end up happening is it's good, even though these abilities are all just basic kind of things, if you're needing, especially for end game grinding stuff, if you wanna complete a lot of abilities, I was adjusting. It's good to have a shop like this where you can buy the basics, because then you'll need to start branching out and leveling up quickly to then meld into new commands and stuff. It's all a thing. It's all a big old thing going on. Forget which, let me go in here, I think, first. Yeah, it's just a room with treasures. Attack recipe. A recipe that lists and reveals what you'll create if your melding combination will result in basic attack commands. So in the synthesis, the recipes, instead of just allowing you to be able to create them, it'll actually let you know what you're going to make before you make it, so you're not just wasting items. So there's a slight difference from Kingdom Hearts 2. Alright, let's see what we got with Maleficent here. Got to level up. Nice.
Fire! Take that.
Block.
Want some?
Put him to sleep. Nice crowd control kind of move. Thunder Chaser. Oh yeah, this ability is kind of interesting. You can move it around and you can zap people. do the zappity zaps.
Take that. Let's go.
Zapped. I'm gonna pause really quick. Live on stream. There's I seeth a spider on my wall, so I'm going to get him. Sorry for the loud noise if there is one. But you know the rules on bugs in my apartment, in my domain. Oh, I missed. Uh-oh, he's trying to run away. Uh-oh, that ain't happening. That ain't happening. It's happening. He's getting away. Shit. Oh, he's down in there now. Oh, God. He outsmarted me. I've been outsmarted by the bug. By the common spider.
Take that. Fire.
Want some? Zap, 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 zap.
Take that. Fire.
Ow. Want some? There we go. There's the level up thing. There it is. Focus saver.
Let's go.
So again, a nice ability, focus saver. I think it just, if you do shot lock commands, I think it just costs less to use it. Or something along those lines. So again, a nice little ability. Now if that bug comes back. Oh, I love the boss, this weird boss techno fighting music in this game. Now look at the design of this unburst. It's a fucking spinning wheel. Sewing wheel or whatever they're called. Also, let's try not to die here. Ow. Like I'm about to do. Attack the wheel while it's dead. Okay, well, already off to a bad start here. Also, I realized I didn't bring items or equip any items like I probably should have. So this is gonna be bad. Oh! How could this be, he says. We're gonna just retry that real quick. And try not to be bad. Like I said, this is always bound to happen when I play Proud mode. Early on in the game, I'm like just too lax. But I gotta. Oh, F off out of that. Oh, come on, I jumped that. Oh, I had to just do it.
Take that.
Maleficent, go! Oh, there we go, got some health balls. Put him on fire. There, that's really helpful. Now I should probably try guarding against that. Oh, he's angry. Uh-oh. I'm gonna die. Block. Block like your life depended on it. I'm so bad at games. I'm so bad. Okay, I need a good stretch. I should probably go into turn into Aqua so I can heal myself. And again, try not to be bad at games. Also, I was blocking that. I feel like it was cheap attacks on me there. Nope. Say goodbye. There we go. Oh, I should have been beating up his weapon. That gives me so much trouble. There we go. Oh, it's chasing his wheel. Oh, I tried to beat him to it. Block! There we go. Much better time. This go around. Oh, I tried blocking. Just to be safe. There we go. Deck capacity increasing is going to be very nice. And learned Diamond Dust command style. But deck capacity increasing, it's going to actually allow me to easily put a potion in until I get a cure.
It was because I was weak. I'm sorry.
He is sorry.
I'll get your light back. Once I learn to stand up against the darkness. Why would Master Xehanort imprison the light? The purest hearts of light. Do they hold the answer?
Seven pure hearts, each completely void of darkness. Such a search may take some time.
Some time, like until Kingdom Hearts 1. Fairy Stars, keyblade that provides a balance boost in strength and magic. Alright, you finished that world. And we've unlocked a couple more. What could that world be? What could that world be? Who knows? Okay, so that will probably do it for the stream. I know it seemed relatively short, but that was the intention. I just wanted to kind of get the beginning part of the game done, and like I did, the first world done too, which is pretty nice. We've got those worlds. Next time I stream this, I'll probably be a bit more beefier. I'll probably be, like I said, doing the command board game off stream here. Level up a couple abilities or whatever that way. Maybe have a couple new abilities. But yeah, then we'll continue on to these worlds. We got Castle of Dreams coming up. We got Dwarf Woodlands. I think Castle of Dreams I'll do next. But yeah, that is gonna do it for the stream right now. Totally expect to stream later on today, probably tonight. I don't know if I'll play this. I'd most likely play something else. Probably is gonna be Bloodborne tonight, later tonight, after I've done some things and have eaten some food and done all that. I'm checking real quick. Who no, I'm not going to pass anyone along to someone else. No one worthy of that that I follow. But yeah, that'll do it. That'll do it for the stream. I appreciate you watching. I appreciate you doing all that streaming stuff. Watching archives, following, doing any of that. We're in November 1st. So we've got, obviously almost end of the year, but we've got about, I think last time I checked, 89 days to Kingdom Hearts 3. So we still got a ways to go. It'll be done. But like I said, following is always appreciated. Watching archives. You can follow me on Twitter. That's bubmanXIV. I always post when I go live. Other than that, I don't have much else to say other than my normal tagline, be kind. Thank you for watching. I appreciate you. Bye.